Israelites saw the law. We the Hebrew Israelites, according to the Bible. And we come out week in and week out to prophesy the downfall of America, which is Babylon the Great in the scriptures, Egypt, Sodom and Gomorrah, all right, Chaldea, according to the Holy Scriptures, man. And before we go into our lesson, man, we just want to start off by giving all honor, glory, and praises to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Vahashim, Yahweh Shah. Double honor to our elders and our apostles at Great Millstone who rule well for teaching us the truth. And salutations to your elect brothers out there in the four corners, laboring in the truth and pushing with all righteousness and sincerity. We say Shalom.
Shalom.
You know, just through the Spirit, we wanted to get into a quick lesson talking about these false prophets out here, man. Okay? These Louis Farrakhan's, these goddamn T.D. Jakes, man. T.D. Bakes, okay? This goddamn Dr. Martin Luther King spirit niggas, okay? And through the Spirit, we're just gonna go into all of that, man, because these guys have been misleading the whole nation of Israel, man. These guys are fucking sellouts, man.
Right.
All
right?
And through the Spirit, we're gonna get into that. Could you give me Isaiah 8:20, Bible for sure?
Yeah.
You know? Because Yahweh Shem HaShah, man. But Yahweh Shah, who the word entering the code, Jesus Christ, when he was on the scene, he told Peter, if you love me, feed my sheep. All right? And that's what we're doing, man. We're giving you the true words of this doctrine. Okay? So that way you can come back to the Heavenly Father.
All right. Go ahead, huh?
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 8, verse 20. To the law and to the testimony, if they speak not according to this word, it's because there is no light in them. And I got a few names of these guys who have no light in them. All right? Louis Farrakhan, T.D. Jakes, Nate, all right? Brother Polite, Yohana, Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Creflo Dollar, Elijah Muhammad, Yahweh Ben Yahweh. Hey, all you guys are not teaching according to this word, man. All right? You have no light in you. You are full of darkness, man. And you are leading the people to destruction. Like the scriptures say what? Like sheep to the slaughter, man. Are you leading two-thirds of our people to get killed? Two-thirds. Let me get the sound right quick. Two-thirds of the nation of Israel. You are leading them into destruction, man.
That's right.
Okay? And Yahweh Shem HaShah is going to get with you guys, man.
I got to preach that right quick.
Go ahead.
Brothers, you brought out the scripture, man. If they're not speaking to you according to this word, there ain't no light in them, man. All right?
And this is John chapter 7. In verse 38, it says, he that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water, man.
All right,
so if you with this, you got a flow of living waters in you, man. You got life in you, man. You got light in you, all right? And we just read the scripture before. If you ain't teaching according to this book, there's no light in you, man.
That's right.
All right, the scripture say you come in the volume of this book, man.
God.
All right, there's no way you should be twisting and turning the scripture.
That's
all right, if you really want to be a prophet for the Lord, man.
God, all right.
God. And the scriptures say you should not, you ought not to add to the words of Yahweh Shem HaShah, man.
God.
All right, because whether you, if you add from it or you take away from it, you're going to die, man.
God.
All right, that's going to be your end. Your end is going to be destruction, man. All right? So the next scripture we're going to get. Matter of fact, go back to that scripture right quick, Bob Michelle. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 8, verse 20. It says, to the law and to the testimony, if they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them. And like we said earlier, man, there's no light in you guys, man. That word light goes back to the Hebrew word awar, man. Okay? And it's also symbolic for wisdom. Okay? The wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of these scriptures. You guys go into the Bible and break the scriptures all down wrong, man. Okay, that's why you got the new English translations and verses and so on and so forth, man. Okay, so you can teach the congregation what? Prosperity.
That's right.
There's going to be prosperity in Babylon, man. Hey, to hell with that.
That's right.
You guys have no light in you.
Hey, the true men of the Lord don't want to prosper on this side, man.
That's right.
The true men of the Lord ready to see this place burn in flames, man.
That's right.
God, if you could go to Matthew, the 15th chapter, go to the 13th verse.
All right. You know? And we call it for the destruction of you guys too, man.
15 and 13.
Yeah, 15 and 13.
God.
This is the book of Matthew. You ready?
God,
this is the book of Matthew, chapter 15, verse 13. But he answered and said, red letter, alright? Every plant which my heavenly Father have not planted shall be rooted up. Hey,
Read that one more time.
God, it says, every plant which my heavenly Father have not planted shall be rooted up.
Hey, and that's going into you false pastors, man. Okay? Because here it is, man. Y'all in the church houses, which is the harlot houses according to the scriptures, and y'all feeding these false philosophies, man. Y'all went out, and Yahabah Shema Hashem did not send you guys out, man. Because what? You guys are still eating pork? Alright, you still fucking the congregation woman? Alright, the men in the congregation woman, I should say, man. Alright, committing adultery, and so on and so forth, man. Yahabah Shema Hashem did not send you guys out. Alright, y'all believe that, man. Y'all teaching in the name of Jesus, man. And Yahabah Shema Hashem is gonna pluck you guys up, man.
Yeah, you pulling the weeds, man.
That's right.
If you know anything about like gardening and farming and raising crops, you know you gotta pluck them weeds in order to have a better crop.
That's right.
Not contaminated crop.
That's right.
And that's what the Lord is doing for the men of the Lord. He's removing those weeds, so the men of the Lord ain't gotta be defiled and have a distractions in this truth, man.
That's right.
Alright,
that's right. Read it one more time.
Now this is Matthew 15:13. But he answered and said, every plant which my heavenly Father have not planted shall be rooted up.
Yeah, you're gonna be rooted up, man. You're gonna be taken out of it, man.
Right.
And that's why, Yahabah Shema Hashem is getting with you guys, man. Okay? That's why your sons are faggots, man. To you both pastors, are you both prophets? Your sons are faggots.
Right.
Your daughters are harlots. Your wife's a harlot.
Right.
Okay? That's why your family is all jacked up, man. All right? Yahabah Shema Hashem is taking you out the picture.
Right. All right?
Because we don't really hear from Nate no more. Hear from Yohana and the rest of you guys no more, man.
If we damn sure don't see you on the highways and the byways.
Exactly.
Read
verse 14.
Matthew 15:14. It says, let them alone. They be blind leaders of the blind.
They be blind leaders of the blind, man, because they blind themselves because Yahabah Shema Hashem blinded them, man. Okay? By way of the angels. The angels came down and they're covering them, man. So that way they're not able to obtain this true word, man. They're not able to get this doctrine. Okay? So all of you guys who's following these Sunday pastors and so on and so forth, these punk chubby pastors, y'all gonna die too because y'all blind, all right? And y'all following the blind, man.
Right.
And read that one more time.
It's Matthew 15:14. It says, let them alone.
Uh-huh.
They be blind leaders of the blind.
God, hey, y'all are blind leaders of the blind, man.
Right.
Your Nate C. Yohannes, Louis Farrakhan's, and so on and so forth, man. You guys are blind leaders of the blind, man. And two-thirds of our people, of these so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, are blind, man, spiritually
right.
Blind.
God.
They're not able to get this truth, man.
God.
It's a stumbling block to you.
God, go ahead.
It says, and if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch.
Hey, both of y'all gonna fall into a ditch, man. All right, two-thirds of our people, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you gonna fall into a ditch by listening to these punk champion pastors, man. Your Louis Farrakhan's, your Nate's, your Yohannes, okay? Your Martin Luther King guys, man. Your Malcolm X guys, y'all gonna fall into a ditch, man.
Obama.
All right, the Kanye West spirits, man.
God.
You guys are gonna die, man. And that ditch is destruction.
God.
You guys are gonna die out here.
God.
All right, you got something?
Nah, go ahead.
All right, Carl, I'll go to Isaiah 30:9.
Open this up.
You know, this is the book of Isaiah 30:9. It says that this is a rebellious people. Lying children, teaching children that will not hear the law of the Lord.
That's right. Continue on.
It says, which say to the seers, see not.
God.
And to the prophets,